CBOA, the Connecticut Bowling Operators Association, welcomes you once again, ladies and gentlemen, to another Duck Pin Challenge. We're pleased to welcome you also to the T-Bowl Lanes on the Berlin Turnpike in Newington, Connecticut. And we have a special bowling tournament for you today. Craig Self is here to give you all a color commentary, along with myself, Norm Peters. Craig, who are our bowlers today?
We've been waiting 2 weeks now. It's Swede Lavers and Peter Pierce. We'll tell you all about them once we get started on the match.
Okay, and we'll be right back in a moment, and you'll see our bowlers in action and know all about them, too.
Okay, Norm, this is the match we've been waiting for the last couple of weeks. We've mentioned how Swede Lavers is going to challenge Peter Pierce for supremacy on the challenge. It's a special version. We're going to have three games today. Each game carries a $100 prize with it, and the overall pinfall for the three games is another $200. We're going to start today with Swede.
Swede Lavers at Stratford, Connecticut. Getting a nice hand from our gallery, the number one bowler presently in the country, and Peter Pierce of Attleboro, Massachusetts, one of the greatest bowlers of all time. See what we mean? They don't fool around. A lot of respect for each other, these gentlemen, who are excellent friends.
Swede delivered that one from the far right-hand side of the approach, cross alley, right into the 1-3 pocket.
Little light, too far to the right.
It's not moving.
No, it's not going anywhere.
Here comes another one.
Back, though. Not quite. Sherman Moving Company just walked in. There it is.
There we start with two marks.
Doesn't fool around. Watch that one again. Boom.
Swede and Peter bowl each other all over the country where duck pins is rolled. Peter's from Attleboro, Massachusetts.
Oh, look at this.
It's what it's all about, folks.
Swede was telling me the respect he has for Peter. He says the man does not let up 1 second. Extremely competitive. What's that say in the back of his jacket? Turn around, Peter. I want to see it one more time.
USA 1983. You may recall a week ago when Swede was working with us on the commentary, there was a U.S. team that went to Canada, Toronto, in 83. Mm-hmm. And teams from four other nations competed.
World Cup, Team Canada. There it is. Sometimes people soften their shot when they go for the final pin standing there alone. He doesn't let up one iota.
I'm certain as the match progresses today, Peter would not miss that. Swede is so anxious to come back over.
Picked the wrong alley.
Line 30. He's got to go back to 29 and come over.
Didn't bother him, though.
Yeah, nine fill. So as early as it is in the match, Swede holds a 10-pin lead after two frames. And Swede returns the favor.
There it is. 10. 49 in the third frame for Swede. Shaking his head. High single game of 245, high three game set of 583.
At the time he set the
588
three
game
set.
Yeah,
that was the New England record. He still holds the world record for six game total pinfall of 1,068 pins.
There. Swede, 18 times has been in the top 30 in the country. Here's Peter, high single game 244. And high three game set of 545, a composite average of 148.
Peter ripped through the center on that one.
What do you hear about his accomplishments?
He almost made that. The pin is laying against the base of the three pin.
Thrilled to watch two bowlers so competitive and so expert in what they're doing.
Last two or three years, Peter's been the top tournament winner in bowling in the Pro Tour.
Watch it again, replay. Like that pin said, I'm coming over to get you, boy.
It's right there. Oh, Swede rips the middle.
Not far enough to the right.
65 for four frames. Good try, just hit it too solid, didn't go anywhere.
Now let's see what he's going to do.
Get at least two. Swede's the manager of Barnum Lanes down in Stratford, Connecticut. Grew up in Stratford, Connecticut, Stratford High School. Served in the Korean War in the Army.
Oh, what a heartbreaker. It looked like one of those pins was going to take it down, but it didn't.
Good fill. New England horseshoe pitching champion back in the early 50s.
And he is 50 years old.
Peter's only 34.
Married, one child.
Yeah.
15-year-old Peter Jr. Look at his occupation, instrumentation calibrator.
Right, he's in the aerospace industry with Northrop at Norwood, Mass.
Never mind being one, you almost can't say it. Instrumentation calibrator. It's a mouthful.
Peter has a chance to go back into the lead here in the fifth frame. He's 69 plus his fill. Swede has 74. 9. He's sporting a 4-pin lead through 5.
Very close game so far.
And he made it. Sweet has a Mark DeFell in the sets.
Number one ranking in Connecticut and New England, 70, 80, 82, 83, and 84.
Right in the 1-2 pocket. Another 9 fell. Unless this pen can get a little acceleration.
Got it.
And so Swede marks in the 8th frame. Peter with his 4-pin lead through 5.
To prove the old adage that practice makes perfect, Peter Pierce practices 4 hours a week. 4 hours a week.
The pen.
That was a heartbreaker.
The pen actually hit the 9.
Yeah, it
just
wobbled.
Wouldn't go.
Peter bowls in 1 league per week. He is a lefty personified.
Looking to get another one here. Keep this match real close.
Oh, right down the middle.
Oh, he ripped. Let's see how he tries to make this.
Did a good job.
Yeah, he goes for the inside. Last week when Swede was helping us with commentary, we were talking about just that. And he said,
look at this.
Right. He said at that time, Peter Pierce would go on the inside trying to make it, get the fly around.
There it is again.
Makes his 10 for the frame. 119 for 8 for Peter Pierce. 133 for Swede.
Frame. Swede is ahead 14 pins. He's up 14.
These guys move along, don't they?
Really? This will be 3 games in a row. $100 per game for the winner. $200 to the man with the greatest total pinfall. Swede labors in Stratford, Connecticut. The reigning number one bowler in the country, bowling against Peter Pierce of Attleboro, Massachusetts, one of the greatest bowlers of all time. You're seeing some accuracy here today.
There's no question about it. We've got the best bowlers here today.
Look at this.
172 game.
172 for Swede.
So Peter needs a double to catch him in this game.
There it is, one of them. He says, don't count me out yet.
Had every chance, didn't it? Bouncing around.
Sure did. Well, sure, he's disappointed on that one. He knew what he had to do, and he
this
went
is what,
for it.
When you got 3 games, he's going to be a leg down after the first game.
Oh,
but look for him to come back.
He played it right.
Going for a 148 possible.
And he got it.
Yep.
172 to 148. Sweet over Peter. We'll be back for game number two in a moment. You take a rest while we do two in a moment. And we're back for game number two as Peter Pierce comes to the line to begin.
Norm, we saw some pretty hot and heavy shooting there, but there were no doubles. Peter had two strikes, Sweet had three. Almost saw a strike there. Mm-hmm. Peter starts with a spare.
Plenty of marks. And Swede has a chance to answer him.
They averaged 160 between the two of them in that first game. That's just a little over their averages when you figure that Pete's right up there at 150 and Swede's right up there. Swede had a 153 average a couple years ago to lead the nation. 2 years before that, he had a 151 average.
It's a great average.
Swede starts with a 10. Peter's on the spare. Swede manages the Barnum Lanes in Stratford.
Ah, he got it.
And when you manage a lane, I guess you get a little practice in now and then. Keeps you on top of your game. This looks difficult, but if that head pin stands up, it's just another shot. All you have to do is hit either side of that head pin. He'll probably come across it from left to right. Correction. He went in on the left-hand side.
Peter went to Attleboro Trade High School in Attleboro, Massachusetts.
That's where you learn to become an instrumentation calibrator.
Mechanic of some type. I wonder if he learned mechanics on how to figure out how to knock these pins down. He has a hobby for metal detecting, and he also likes chess.
He's a chess player.
Strategy.
Strategies. He has a strategy about bowling, too. It's,
sure
it's get out in front as far as you can, as fast as you can, and don't look back.
Look this. Nowhere. He is a pin bowler, not a spot bowler. He takes three steps with a long slide. See that?
Yep. 36 through three. And the interesting thing about this particular game is he's got the same pattern that he had in the first game, where he spared in the first frame, left two frames open, and then he came back with strikes and marks from there.
Now, Swede practices 1 hour before a tournament, where Peter says he practices 4 hours. I beg your pardon, 12 hours before a tournament.
Before a major tournament,
yes,
Peter will put in a lot of practice. And it's paid off. He wins more tournaments than anyone else. So. Swede covers a strike with a spare fill.
Wow, talk about flying ducks.
Oh, it left the lane.
Mm-hmm. Totally.
If we had a pin boy, we'd go retrieve it.
And he gets it.
So he has three marks. Now this is where Peter struck in the last game, fourth frame.
Oh, look at that. One by one. One at a time. Take him any way he can get him.
I'll bet you didn't think this was going to go.
No way.
He hit the head pin very full. Very full, uh-huh. But he has enough action.
Look at this.
To make it.
You know the old story. I'll take him any way I can get him.
You know, Norm, a lot of people will be watching this today, and they'll say, you know, Peter Pierce throws the ball so hard, and that's what, you know, I'll have to do, especially young bowlers. The one thing that you've got to remember is that if you watch his approach, it's very deliberate. He knows exactly. He's got his balance at all times.
He knows exactly where he has to put the ball, where it has to hit. Every time he delivers the ball. And the same for Sweet. But it always doesn't go where you want it to go. And anybody starting out bowling duck pins will find that out very, very quickly.
Sweet will probably cover this one. His object pin is his three pin. He's just going to come in on either side of it.
See that?
Sure. Here he comes right into the right-hand side of that three pin. You know, the thing that I find very interesting is Swede was on 2 weeks ago when he bowled against Carl Tenty and rolled a 140.
Right.
Now, Carl Tenty's a very good bowler, but Carl Tenty doesn't bowl the number of tournaments nationally that Swede gets
that
into
Swede
or
does,
that
yeah.
Peter does. And I think he gets really pumped up to bowl the top bowler, the very top bowler.
And he defeated
country.
Swede, yeah. Well, it didn't work that time. He's got a toughie here. No soap.
Third ball, 83 through six.
Yeah.
And Swede Lavers has 96 working on a strike in the sixth. So Swede's got 13 pin advantage at least.
In the fifth frame.
Sixth.
In the sixth,
yeah. Watch. Oh. But we're going to see some real interesting pin action here.
Oh.
Caught a,
by a whisker.
Caught a piece of it.
Yeah. Here it is again. Side angle. Show you his form.
So Swede adds 9 to that 13. He's 22 pins up through 6. Already gets another ball.
Swede was telling me at the beginning of the tournament before we got going about the respect he has for the man, Peter. He thinks he's the finest bowler he has ever seen. Of course, he's talking about young men, too, as compared to people his own age.
Right. Swede has bowled, of course, against some of the legendary bowlers, but of the crop of bowlers that heads
coming up
the Duckman bowling to Dice. He probably feels that Peter's the top competitor. Buddy Kramer. In his day, Nick Tronsky, of course, was just about unbeatable year after year after year in the 30s, 40s, 50s. A near miss.
Last week he was here with us at the microphone, helping us with our color commentary, giving us some background information on a few of the bowlers and his own personal observations. And he's a delightful individual to talk to work with. And it doesn't seem to bother him at all to be behind a microphone.
No,
he seems to be more bothered bowling than to be behind the microphone.
Well, I don't think, I don't believe that.
Well, that's what he was telling us anyhow.
I know, but I don't believe it. He's a really friendly bowler and uplifting to all who are bowling with him. Peter's got a little opening here, so we'd left two frames without a mark, and Peter can get within 12 on this ball. It's back over on that two pin all the time.
That's a bad split. Well, the further what I was saying before, what Swede was telling us about being on the lanes, as opposed to being behind the microphone, he says you're in front of a large gallery, in front of cameras, and you get a lot of lights on you. He said the pressure is even worse. He said that bothers him more so than if he was just bowling in a regular tournament.
Yes, that could very well be, because his experience in TV shows, even years ago, I recall he was on a lot of shows, but he only won one of them. Mm-hmm. He's in the driver's seat right now.
He sure is. 17-pin advantage.
The last pin to come out of that on that leaf there is a 5-pin. If the 5 had remained standing, it would have been an extremely difficult spare, of course. His wife and daughter are here today. Wife Jill. Daughter Tara.
He's a Korean War veteran. United States Army, I should say.
Right on.
And Peter has not served at all. He's not a veteran.
Okay, Swede.
Nice strike. He's turning the old pressure on.
Don't be surprised if Peter Pierce comes back with a 200 game. I've seen it so many times with this guy.
Even Peter was glad for that. Sweet got that strike. I shouldn't say even, but he was.
Sweet's held it at 163.
They shake hands. What can be going through Peter's mind now?
He says, I came to Connecticut. I'm playing on Swede's own home turf.
Right.
I love match play like this. You know, they used to do it years ago where bowlers from one area would bowl against the bowler from another area, set up match exhibitions.
This is only the second game of this match. We have another one to go between these two gentlemen. Swede Labors of Stratford, Connecticut, and Peter Pierce of Attleboro, Massachusetts. Prize money, $100 per game, $200 for the one who has the highest total pinfall.
136 game.
Okay, there you have the second game, and we'll be up with the third and final game in a moment after these messages. We'll be right back.
ready for game three. Swede Lavers has taken the first two games by scores of 172 to 148 and 163 to 136. Now the format calls for $100 per game and $200 for total pinfall. So Peter could conceivably come in here with one of those big games of his, that 225 or 30 game, and turn this whole thing around for himself.
Swede won the first game by 24 pins, and the second game by 27 pins.
What's that, 51?
Mm-hmm. That's what it is.
That went from a very difficult spare to an easy one for Peter. They both start with spares. Plus 51 for Swede Lavers.
Good ball.
Just about perfect.
Waiting for the correct ball to come back. Spare on a spare.
So often we get into bowlers who have just exactly one way of delivering the ball. They start at a certain point, they deliver it exactly the same every time. You talk to Swede Lavers, and his approach to it is he'll spot bend and spot bowl, or he'll pin bowl, or he'll pick out a board and
sure.
Do that. And how many steps would he take? Well, he'll take three steps, or he'll take four steps, or he'll take five steps. And where are you going to deliver the ball from? I don't know if I'm going to deliver it from the right-hand side of the approach or the left-hand. He says, I just do whatever it has to do to make it happen.
It's like ask him how he's going to do it.
You're going to bowl left-handed or right-handed?
He says, any way I can to knock the pins down.
Pro Tour wins.
Wamisit Lanes.
In Tewksbury. Another one in Annapolis.
Coming in a little too far to the right. He's trying for the one on the three and not getting him. Beautiful ball. Nice spare. Here it is again. Watch this. Well placed.
Peter enjoyed that just as much as Swede. Mm.
Whoops. False start.
Balk. Oh. I'll leave that one up.
That one hurt. That didn't help him at all. Would have helped a spare, but now it's going to hinder it.
Made it nigh onto impossible almost. .47 through 3. Swede has 36 plus a fill. So Peter has a slight lead in this game. Game three of a three-game match. Special edition of Duck Pen Challenge today. Exhibition match, if you will, between Peter Pierce and Swede Lavers. Peter coming in from Attleboro, Massachusetts.
You know, he was a little late getting here today. We were all waiting for him to come, and I went over to Swede and I said, is he here yet? He says, oh yeah, here, he's here. He said, I said, where is he? He says, out in the car eating. I said, eating before a tournament like this? And he says, well, he loves to eat. He can eat anytime, anywhere, and as much as he possibly can.
Thank you.
but it doesn't seem to have affected his game very much. Not totally, anyhow.
Well, he's a little off his game. He's below his average.
Yes. But he does it all the time. Sweet is bowling very well.
Oh. Any predictions?
Yep, no. It is not going to happen. It's on a turntable that doesn't want to go anywhere.
So Sweet can take the lead here with a fill. He's trailing by one in the fourth. However, he has this ball to make up the difference. That's the leave that Peter Pierce almost had back win in the first frame.
Sweet's up by five. Five pins is not an awful lot to be leading by. Not in this game. All right, we'll get back to our competition between Sweet Labors and Peter Pierce of Attleboro, Massachusetts in just a moment. Okay, Duckpin Professional Bowlers Association Pro Tours.
These are events that Peter Pierce has
Peter
won.
Peter Pierce won, right, in 1980, the Brunswick Bowling Center. In 1981, the Greenway Bowl East. In 1982, the Legion Bowlodrome down in Cranston. In 1983, the Fontana Bowl in Silver Spring, Maryland. In 1984, the Legion Bowlodrome in Cranston. In 1985, also the Legion Bowlodrome in Rhode Island.
That kind of has his way at Legion. Won three of them there.
He doesn't stay around home.
Well, that's a sizable accomplishment when you figure that of the 8 to 10 Pro Tour stops that they have per year, he's won six. It means he has to wear six stars on his shirt when he's bowling. There's a lot of other guys that would like to be doing that.
Yes. There's plenty to be proud of.
It's a chance for Peter to surge ahead.
See if he can do it.
Bingo.
Watch it again. We have a replay for you.
Well, here's the first strike of this third game.
Right between the one and the three.
Well, actually, Peter really wants to get back into this match heavy. He's got to do a lot of those right here. In the overall match right now, Swede leads by 44 pins. So for Peter to break that down, he has to strike consecutively here in several frames.
When you look at the list of winnings and tournaments and Pro Tour wins that Swede Labors has, it's like looking at a laundry list going from 1984 all the way back to 1961. the Connecticut State tournaments, the men's doubles in 1982, all events champion of 1975 and 84, and the men's triples in of 84, and the men's singles of 84. That's here in Connecticut alone.
That pin has to be reset. It hit the channel before it took the pin down. So the match will get a little closer.
That's what we're waiting for right now. Connecticut State Tournaments, men's doubles.
1982.
All events champion, 75-84. Men's triples, 84. Men's singles, also 1984.
So the third ball picks up 10 pins for the frame. Sweet. Peter really needed a strike there. He finally has the ball coming up, but it's crossing over the head pin now. Before he was falling short, he was hitting the two pin.
He's got it.
Makes the mark. Trails in this game, or leads in this game rather, by 8. Trails in the overall match by 43. Ooh. 5-7.
Is the third and final game.
Oh, perfect.
Beautiful shot.
One of the best you'll ever see.
Watch this.
Comes right in the right side of that five pin. Just perfect delivery over to the seven.
I saw Sweet shake his hand and say, nice shot, too.
Oh, they appreciate good shooting.
Sure. Of accuracy and anything else you can think of to describe it. Professionalism.
Swede's a great golfer, too.
Have you golfed against him?
No. No, I'm looking forward to it some weekend next spring.
The man is ranked number one in the nation, 82 and 83 and 83, 84. Currently reigning number one champion in duck pin bowling. Here comes Peter Pierce again. 34 years old from Attleboro, Massachusetts. Instrumentation calibrator at Northrop in Norwood, Massachusetts.
Needed that strike. He almost had it. He's 143 plus through 9. Sweet is 125. So there's 18 pins difference plus the fill. But Peter had a 51 pin bulge to overcome going into this third game. Needs a strike.
Peter Jr. is 15 years old. I wonder if he's a bowler.
Well, I'm sure he is.
If he is, he's probably watching on television right now. That is, if they can get Channel 61 up in Attleboro, Massachusetts. I hope it reaches up that far.
His dad's looking to tie the game that Sweet shot in the first game. He's got 162 plus. If he gets a 10 fill, he's got a 172. Mm. 171. fans really appreciate Peter coming down to join Swede in the match today. Let's make it a difficult one here. This is the same spare leave we use on the jackpot, Connecticut Travel Services.
Mm-hmm.
Almost.
And he'll get another chance at. No, he won't either.
No.
Not today.
135 game, 171 for Peter.
Although a couple of weeks ago he had a chance to do it, he didn't do it then either. We'll be back to meet our two challengers in a moment. Okay, we are going to do the Connecticut Travel Services Spirit Jackpot after all because of some remaining time. Going to give our gentleman a chance to win two U.S. air tickets to anywhere the U.S. air flies in the continental United States by knocking down the split. And this is brought to you by the Connecticut Travel Service, the leader in business and vacation travel from Bradley International Airport. Connecticut Travel Service is located in New Britain, Bloomfield, and Manchester. Let's see what our two bowlers can do.
Swede's going to be the first one to try the jackpot today. He has some theories on this. You hit it, the four pin on the right hand side, and it goes into the seven and comes across and takes out the 10. The theory is still intact. Peter says just smash him. Good try, good try.
Reed Labors and Peter Pierce with our spare jackpot. They tried, but they didn't do it. Actually, Swede had two chances to do it, and he didn't get a chance, didn't get a final outcome that he should have had in the first place either time.
Exciting games
exciting,
today.
Extremely
so
exciting.
We need some real good bowling.
Yes.
I'd like to first bring out Peter Pierce. Peter. Appreciate your coming to Connecticut.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Check for $100. Peter, how'd you find the lane conditions today?
Very good, very good. I just was off a bit. I just didn't have it, one of my off days.
Was your family watching up there?
No, they couldn't make it today. They couldn't make it.
They couldn't make it at all, huh? Well, we appreciate your coming down, as Craig said, and congratulations to you, and don't spend it all at once.
All right.
Okay.
Thank you very
Thanks
much.
Thanks very much.
Swede.
Here's the man who took it all.
Congratulations, $400.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. And how did you feel about your bowling today?
Terrible.
Oh, come on.
Well, it is. It's a case where I scored well and bowled terrible. And if I catch Peter on another day like this and I throw the same ball, I'm going to get murdered, and I
okay.
know it.
Thank you very much, Swede.
Thank you.
That's all we have for you today, ladies and gentlemen. We hope again we'll see you next week. Bye-bye for now.